The Crows are seething tonight after becoming the first team to lose a player to the new AFL franchise, Greater Western Sydney. Phil Davis just couldn't say no to a reported multi-million dollar offer, and he's played just 18 games.
Davis's defection is a bitter blow to the Crows, and they're not hiding their anger.
Yeah, now he's the enemy, and he'll be treated as such.
We don't have lockers for the enemy in here, so he's cleaned out his locker and he'll move on.
Harsh words for a 20-year-old to hear, but if a teammate's prediction about his pay packet is true, he's got $800,000 a year from Greater Western Sydney to help cushion the blow.
I'm not going to lie, that money is a factor, but for me it's a decision about my football. There are things there that I really want to, I would like to do, and that excites me there.
Davis's predecessor at centre-half back, Nathan Bock, was just as excited last year when he too left the Crows for the new Gold Coast franchise.
Well, obviously our club's bloody disappointed. Welcome to the new world of AFL footy. We live in now a ridiculously inflated market for AFL players.
After telling teammates of his decision, Matthew Yench put the suggested size of his pay packet on social media.
He's an idiot sometimes, Matty.
Is he on the
mark? I'm not going to go into detail, but no.
This afternoon, the Crows, naturally minus Davis, were out planting trees as part of a community program. Clearly disappointed, money has lured away one of their future leaders.
Which can only be said as a monetary one, and the club's very disappointed, players are disappointed, and the AFL has created it, so we've got to deal with it.
The Crows believe losing Phil Davis is even worse than losing Nathan Bock, because he was a developing player that could have been with the club for another 10 years. Adelaide's only positive, the poaching is over for now.
At least we don't have to do this again until there's another new team in the competition.
James Wakeland, 10 News.